أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمداً رسول الله، أشهد أن محمداً رسول الله، حي على حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله،
إن الحمد لله تعالى نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، يعني إن شاء الله يعني بداية من هذه الجمعة المباركة ستكون هناك خطبة باللغة العربية في الساعة 1:30 والثالثة والنصف. إن شاء الله starting from this Friday we will have two khutbah in Arabic, one in 1:30 and the other one in 3:30. So this should be in Arabic, but because I see a lot of faces of our brothers who don't speak Arabic yet, inshallah eventually they will talk Arabic in future, inshallah, because Arabic is the language of Muslims. This is our official language. And you know, Canada is a bilingual language country. So they speak English and French, and every document you get from the government, it carries two languages, English and French. And this is Muslims everywhere. So you have your own tongue, whatever language you raised, your mother tongue is plus Arab, inshallah. Inshallah, inshallah, after Ramadan, we'll have good program. Inshallah, I hope everyone will join this program in Arabic, if you teach Arabic, inshallah. فأنا I will mix, inshallah. فإنشاءالله اليوم نكمل مسيرتنا مع كيف نصلح أمتنا. يعني how we fix our ummah, how to bring our ummah back on the right track, what we should do. And subhanallah, when we see the word al-islah or salah في القرآن, كلمة الإصلاح في القرآن, نجد أن كلمة الصلاح وكلمة الفلاح تقريبا نفس الحروف, يختلف في الفاء والصاد. يعني the word فلاح success and صلاح. صلاح in English, there is many translation. They don't have one word for it. And this is the beauty of Arabic. Sometimes the word have a lot of meaning. You can say fix, correct, reform, rectify, renovation. All of them meaning صلاح أو إصلاح. To repair something, to fix something. لكن في اللغة العربية هناك دلالة جميلة جدا أن الحروف, أن الكلمات التي بها أحرف متشابهة توجد بينها علاقة. هناك قرابة بين هذه الكلمات التي فيها تشترك في نفس الحروف, سواء كل الحروف أو معظم الحروف. فإحنا we're talking about there is a relationship between the words in Arabic that have the same letters. وأشهر شيء العلم والعمل. عين لام ميم, عين ميم لام, نفس الحروف ولكن يعاد ترتيبها تعطيك كلمة العلم أو كلمة الإيه؟ العمل. لأنه لا قيمة, يعني هما وجهان لعملة واحدة. The ilm, knowledge, and amal, action, same letters, they are one coin, same, like one coin with two faces. You cannot separate them. لا نستطيع أن نفصل بين العلم والعمل. ولذلك العرب تقول العلم ينادي بالعمل والا فارتحل. يعني knowledge will call actions, will the things to do, otherwise علم will leave. Because what is the value of books, of علم, without implementing? And if you implement something without knowledge, it will be a disaster. قل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة. This is the way of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. I call people to follow the deen of Allah on بصيرة, with vision, with you know what you are doing. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى in the Quran giving us a beautiful analogy, مثال رائع. وهذه الآية نزلت في أهل الكتاب ولكنها تنطبق على المسلمين لأن المخاطب بها المسلمون. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى مثل الذين حملوا التوراة ثم لم يحملوها كمثل إيه؟ الحمار يحمل أسفارا. The analogy or the example of those who were carried or were given the book, the holy books, Bible and the Torah, and they don't follow it, like the donkey carrying a lot of books, a lot of knowledge. What the donkey will do with the knowledge on his back? Nothing. So if we memorize, mashallah, it's good to memorize the Quran and the Hadith and the Fiqh, and we know what to do. But if we don't implement it, if you don't do what you know, we'll be like the donkey who carry books without using them. So subhanallah, salaha and falaha. Same letter, the sad and fa. Subhanallah, even before the dots, because قبل النقاط والتشكيل كانت نفس الحروف. فصالح وفلح متلازمتان لأن الصلاح هو الذي يؤدي إلى الفلاح. فهناك علاقة بين الصلاح والفلاح. There is a relationship between fixing and repairing and the success. والصلاح له معنيان. معنى الأول أن الله سبحانه وتعالى يعطيك شيء فأنت تحافظ عليه كما هو. أن تبقيه كما هو. يعني أن تبقي على جسدك كما هو. أن تبقي على سيارتك كما هي. أن تبقي على أي جهاز في البيت التكييف أو السخان كما هو. هذا إصلاح لأنك تبقيه على ما هو عليه. So the first meaning is to maintain the thing the way the designer recommended. So when you have your body, you maintain your body without any damage. This is إصلاح. صلاح. You maintain your car. This is صلاح. Like you take your car for every 5,000 kilometer or 20,000 kilometer, there is no problem, but you maintain the car. This is صلاح. The other meaning, المعنى الآخر للصلاح هو أن يكون شيء قد كسر وأنت تعيده إلى حالته الأولى. Something was broken and you bring it back to the normal condition. So either you keep it on the normal condition, you run it in the normal condition, or something wrong and you bring it back to normal condition. So this is the most important two meaning of salah. And we have many examples in the Quran. يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى when you're talking about زكريا فاستجبنا له ووهبنا له يحيى وأصلحنا له زوجة. الله سبحانه وتعالى about زكريا, الله أصلحنا له زوجة. We fixed your wife to be able to be pregnant and deliver a boy again. So because she doesn't have the ability to be pregnant after she was, you know, I mean, she was old and so on. So there is a lot of examples in the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala complimented many of the prophets and the righteous people. And we mentioned this before about Ibrahim. Subhanallah, many times Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Ibrahim, our father Ibrahim alayhi salam. وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ فُرْعِيسَ وَسَيِّدًا وَحَصُورًا وَنَبِيًّا مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ and so on. There is a lot of الصلاح. So how we relate this to our what we want to do? Now we have the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we have us, the community. We are the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we have the deen, which is the operating or the operation manual, how to function. So we have to run us, we have to run the community with salah as per the instructions from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very simple. And this will make you, me, the community, the universe, lead to success. So we have to maintain what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us to be able to achieve falah. Okay, this is very important because we cannot achieve success without following the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني دون أن نتبع الشرع لا نستطيع ولن نستطيع أن نحقق أي صلاح وبالتالي لن نستطيع أن نحقق الإيه؟ الفلاح. كثير من الناس يقولوا الفلاح يكون في الآخرة فقط. وهذا معنى قاصر. الفلاح يكون في الدنيا والآخرة. الفلاح يكون في الدنيا والآخرة. وكما قلنا من قبل الفلاح يعني بذل الجهد مع تحقيق النتيجة. So فلاح mean you do the effort and achieve the result. Both of them. You cannot just gain your certificate without studying, without working hard. So الفلاح شخص تعب بذل المجهود وسهر الليالي وقدم الكثير حتى يحقق الفلاح سواء في الدنيا أو في الإيه أو في الآخرة. وهذا لا يكون إلا بالإصلاح. فكأن الطريق الذي يجب أن نسير عليه في حياتنا هو إيه؟ هو طريق الصلاح. والآيات كما ذكرت كثيرة والحديث كثير. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إنما بعثت لأتمم في معنى مكارم الأخلاق، وفي رواية أخرى صالح الأخلاق. فموضوع الإصلاح والصلاح في منتهى الأهمية، أن الإنسان في كل ما يفعل ما هي نيته؟ What is your intention when you do any act? Whatever this is for you, for your family, for your business. What is your intention? Your intention is الصلاح. Your intention is الصلاح. Not for yourself. Not to destroy. People going for wars. We ask them in Russia and Ukraine, NATO and US and Britain and everybody is fighting. Why are you going for war? Why are you killing each other? For صلاح or for corruption, for فساد? Or for personal gain, or for power. No. Muslims, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will give us the program. And our program to achieve success is every act you do it, and your niyyah is to achieve salah. Either by maintaining the function of everything, or by fixing if something happened and you repair it back. This is very important. And again, to relate this to what we are talking in the last few weeks about the our role as ummah to change our conditions. And we said we have this crazy khalifa that decided to leave us and he was not with us anymore. And now we are in charge. Before he went to this mission impossible to Mars, Kawkab al-Mariikh, ولن يعود إلينا, he was not coming back. And he told every one of us, this is the need in the society, this is the need in the community. And every one of you has some capabilities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him ni'ma, talent, power. Allah أعطاك كثير. كيف تستخدم ما حباك الله به وما وهبك الله إياه في أن تسد حاجات المجتمع. You use what Allah gave you to fulfill the need of the community. Very simple. How to make islah in the community. How to make salah in the community. So don't do it in your own. لا تجتهد بنفسك ولا تعتمد على عقلك ولكن اعتمد على الشرع. Use what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to us. So this is the idea. And someone told me, يعني, you, أنت حالم, you are a dreamer, يعني, you dream too much. So you should wake up. So and I will answer him, inshallah, in this khutbah, that what I'm calling for, we do it. Our Muslim community is doing a lot of actions in like individually or collectively together. Example number one, weekend schools. When Muslims came to Canada, alhamdulillah, they built a lot of masajid and community centers. And now we have a problem that the public schools, they don't have educational, Islamic education to our children. So what the community did? Subhanallah, in every city, in every town, without agreeing, without a full agreement between all the Muslims in Canada, كل المسلمين قرروا إن في كل بلدة, في كل مدينة, الآباء والأمهات, الآباء والأمهات, قالوا نستأجر مدرسة, نستأجر أي مكان, community center, we rent a place, public school or a center or whatever, and every weekend, مدارس ال weekend school or مدارس نهاية العطلة, وهناك أصبحوا يعلموا الأولاد التربية الإسلامية, القرآن واللغة العربية. So in this school, we all shared and work with a lot of weekend schools, and most of us volunteered. You know, I mean, even there is any fees, you know, you put your children and you don't take wages because your children in the school, which is mainly, we cover our cost. We just cover our cost. So what we did together, is this the rule of the president or the prime minister? If we have one, if we have a Muslim president or Amir or Wali or Sultan or Khalifa, whatever his name, but because he left us, we have no one. So we take care of ourselves. We said there is a need for you to learn Quran, for you to learn Arabic. So we'll make weekend school and we build a system. And we went to the education board, وأجرنا المدرسة منهم, and we got a school, huh? And we have curriculum, and we have exams and actually high school we have credit for Arabic language, we have credit for high school. By doing this, this is exactly what I'm calling for. We did it, but we need to do it for a lot of our life aspects, a lot of other needs that we want to fulfill. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم فاستغفرونا والغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عبادي الذين اصطفى وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله ثم أما بعد. So we have a lot of examples, الكثير من الأمثلة التي يقوم بها المسلمون يعني حتى قبل المدارس المساجد. أحيانا مسؤولية الخليفة في الدولة الإسلامية أو الرئيس أن يعني يحمي الدين ويدعو الناس إلى الالتزام بالدين منها إنشاء المساجد. لذلك إحنا عندنا مشكلة إن الزكاة لا تعطى لإنشاء المساجد. الزكاة أموال الزكاة مفروض ألا تعطى لبناء المساجد. The زكاة money should not go to build مساجد. This is the fiqh. But because this is back home, front home in Canada, the people, the فقهاء notice that we know we don't have this income from the government. We don't have أوقاف. We don't have all this money, so we cannot build masajid with donation. So we need to take all the money of the zakah to build the masajid. So the ulama allowed for the Muslims living in North America and Europe to pay to build masajid from zakah. So it's okay to donate for the masjid, to build the masjid and to run the masjid. But a need like this, again, Muslim community did it. So we build masajid, Islamic centers, and we build schools, food bank. ما شاء الله إن الإسنا دار هاملتون هالتون موسك كل المساجد all the مساجد have food bank. What is a food bank? It's a social service should be provided by the government. But because again we are running out of a governor for the little Muslim community, we notice there is some people they don't fulfill the conditions to be funded by the government. Okay, because Canada, which is something good about Canada, is a lot. Canada is not a capitalism, like it doesn't belong to capitalism 100% and not socialism 100%. Something in the middle, like Sweden and, you know. So that's good. There's a good social service in Canada, but it's not enough for everyone. So what the Muslim did, we saw a need. So in every masjid, mashallah, over here, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, 100 family every week, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Brother, he had me, Allah reward him and all the brothers and sisters who helped me in this food bank, they fulfill the need of people who need food. And mashallah, they started with little, but now they have meat, you know, they have fruit. Mashallah, it's a very expensive basket that goes to the needy family, especially our brothers who came from different countries after the wars in their countries without naming any countries. So هذه الأعمال التي نقوم بها هي بالضبط ما أدعو لي. So these actions exactly what I'm calling for. But we need to go to larger dimension. Let's tackle more needs in the society. Or sometimes what's happening is we have a need, big gap we have, but the workers, the people who are volunteering and working in this, very little. So they carry a lot of load. This is why they are not able to fulfill it 100%. We have an issue with the human rights. How many of us are lawyers or activists in the human rights? Or at least we help them. Even sometimes, you know, someone working in a case and he needs just to typewrite. It will take him 1 hour. Maybe you just help a lawyer in any case that need, you know, some the number one, people are not able to pay all these high expensive fees to the lawyers. So, mashallah, a lot of brothers, lawyers, they volunteer. But they need someone to write for them. They need someone to help them. They need someone to make some arrangement. So you can help by any means on human rights. What about the conflicts with the youth? I have a brother who talked to me the other week about he's working in hospital. And many Muslims, kids when they come, or youth, when they come to the hospital, and he's telling me it's a given now that everybody is smoking marijuana. It's a given. It's not an option. Everyone comes to the hospital, is drunk or, you know. So he said, there is a lot of problems with youth that we need to achieve. And said he told me, don't think about the people who come to the masjid. Because the people who come to the masjid, most of the time, they are good. Alhamdulillah, bismillah, mashallah. Yani. And if you do something, including myself, let's repent, make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what about the youth who don't come to the masjid? And again, this is, if you are young and youth, this is your field. Because they will not listen to me, ammu or giddu, I'm too old for them. But they will listen to you at school. They listen to you in your college and university. So if you make your intention, even you are young, you can help this youth to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At least prevent the harm from coming to them, smoking, drinking, dating, and so on. Don't undermine yourself. Don't undermine what you can do. في بيت شعر جميل يقول لك يقول لا تحقرن صغيرة إن الجبال من الحصر. يعني لا تستصغر شيء لأن هذا الجبل الكبير هو مجموعة من الإيه؟ من الحصى والصخور الصغيرة. Don't undermine any act you do because the mountains are made of small rocks. And this is why, subhanAllah, I was in Mecca and they open Mecca is, subhanAllah, it's an amazing city. It's mountains, جبال. فكل ما يريدوا أن ينشئوا يعني حي جديد بيكسروا في الجبل. So they want to have a new area, a residential area, they break the mountains. And you can see all these heavy duty machines breaking what? They go and blow the whole mountain. I watched the one guy like with the heavy equipment and he breaking one rock like for 1 hour, but tick, 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 tick. He would break it at the end. Okay? So, you know, you have a problem at school with your friends. Keep working on it. Don't say, oh, it's none of my business. No, it is your business. To fix, to do islah to your friends, to make them come to the masjid. And even if they don't come to the masjid, at least Yom al-Jum'ah, they don't make anything haram. This is your responsibility. It's not only the elder people, the ammu or the uncles. You know, it's everyone's responsibility. So there is something you can do. There is something you can do to change the condition of the ummah. By fixing, by islah, one person. What about if you help someone, even in any subject, in math, in science, so you have free time, and you say, I will donate 2 hours to help my brothers in school for tutoring, so they don't pay tutoring for so and so. So think, dream about the needs of the ummah and fulfill them. You know, many ideas. If you, again, and I'm saying, if you don't have one, come forward and ask your parent first. Of course, help your parent. Take care of your relative. You know, many people, we are, alhamdulillah, are good in Canada. And I'm sure you have people here in Canada that they need your help. And you have back home people that need your help. I know you do a lot, mashallah. But if you take care of one of your family members, someone who is not able to get married, and you say, I will... You know, maybe $1,000 Canadian is not much for you, but for him, he can get married with maybe 10,000 Canadian dollars or 5,000, whatever. Many people say cannot go to perform Hajj or Umrah. You can help them perform Hajj or Umrah. So help your relative, help the people, help the community. Start with the close circle and move on. The message is to do islah. Don't be selfish. Don't think about yourself only. Think about other people in the community, in your circle, in your family. And inshallah, you will find something. You have to find something. And if you can't, come to anyone in the masjid, come to your parent, come ask someone how we can, what I can do to change the condition of the ummah. Inshallah, we will keep, we'll continue our discussions about ideas because I mentioned some ideas last time and I don't want to repeat myself. Inshallah, in future, we will keep repeating, alhamdulillah, I have many people approach me after Jum'ah and after Isha, and they write their names, and we discuss, and we find a lot of great ideas, a lot of good effort. So I want every one of you to have something. Start with Oakville, go Mississauga, Burlington, whatever, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to change our conditions, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help us. Allahumma alimna ma yinfa'una. وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما اللهم ردنا والمسلمين يدينك ردا جميلا اللهم املأ قلوبنا بحبك وحب من أحبك وحب كل عمل يقرب إلى حبك اللهم إنا نسألك من الخير كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم ونعوذ بك من الشر كله عاجله وآجله ما علمنا منه وما لم نعلم. اللهم إنا نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم انصر الإسلام والمسلمين في كل زمان وفي كل مكان. اللهم يسر كل عسير وحرر كل أسير وردهم إلى أهلهم سالمين غانمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم نسألك رضاك والجنة ونعوذ بك من سخطك والنار. اللهم بارك لنا في شعبان وبلغنا رمضان وأعنا فيه على الصيام والقيام وعلى قراءة القرآن وعلى اللهم إنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.